thanks for your interest in the ExoFrame DIY kit. A few things to consider before you get started. Have you ordered utility locates? Have you confirmed your local jurisdiction's requirements for permitting? Remember, you have a choice on which swing window you want, right or left. So from the inside, looking to the outside, tell us which side of the window you would like your hinge on. To aid in the production of this video, we've installed the window well first and the ExoFrame second. I think it's best if you install your ExoFrame first and then finish up with your window well. This video shows two men doing the installation. It's been brought to my attention that two women could do it in half the time. Let me know how that goes. If you're confused about the content of this video or you don't know how to use the tools shown, this may not be in your wheelhouse. Contact a pro. Okay, so we're on site in Inglewood, Colorado. I think it's the last day of winter, and we're wrapping up the installation of a basement escape window for a customer. So the purpose of today's video is to show you how easy it is to install an ExoFrame and to just show you the benefits of it all the way around. We're going to start by applying this butyl gasket to the frame. So I'm just going to apply this to the frame, pressing firmly against the paper so that the butyl adheres to the back of the steel frame. Make a little bump out here at that hole so that when you drill, the butyl does not get caught up in your hammer drill bit. Okay, so we just wrapped up the process of putting the butyl on, and there's alternatives to butyl. If you buy a kit, the 3M butyl comes with the kit. We just think it's better because it's continuous and it's really hardy. You'll see when we tighten these screws down and this butyl gets compressed out from the frame, between the frame and the cement, you'll see what a nice continuous seal it makes. This is what they set automotive windshields with. So when you're driving down the highway 70 or 80 miles an hour, this keeps the water out. And so therefore, it's not going to have any trouble keeping the water out of your egress window. And one of the other benefits of having this butyl sealant is it's not really temperature sensitive. At least the high quality 3M version of butyl sealant is not as heat sensitive as some of the cheaper brands. But anyway, I'm going to proceed with just pulling the paper off. And like I mentioned earlier also, you know, you don't want to leave this out in the direct sunlight when it's starting to get warm because the stuff is so tacky that the butyl will actually adhere to the tape. It's just common sense. You can now see how this is just a continuous seal and how well it's going to seal against the wall. The next step is this goes to me when I get down there. Before we do that, we're going to have to reposition this ExoFrame so that my helper will be able to bring it to me in the hole. So notice when we're going to stand this thing up vertically in a moment, we want to stand it up on concrete or 2x4s or something so that you don't get grass, leaves, and debris on the butyl. So here we go. So here we go, we're going to set the ExoFrame up vertically now on a clean surface, and voila. I like to carry this across my shoulders over to the hole. So I usually just lean into it, put it on my shoulders right there. Next step is lowering the ExoFrame down in the hole and fastening it to the wall. So we've got everything, I've got everything I need right next to me. So when Paul comes over with the ExoFrame, we're ready to go. So I've got my rechargeable drill with a 1/4-inch bit already on it. I've got my impact wrench with an 11mm bit on it. I've got big shims in case my cut's not level, and I've got small shims to tune it up. I'd say we're ready to go. One more thing, before we set the ExoFrame, we want to inspect this wall and we want to make sure that there's no bumps or aberrations that would hold the ExoFrame out from the wall. So sometimes, you know, if you see a little bump, I don't see one right here, maybe one right there, just touch it with the hammer. Oftentimes we'll take a shim and scrape the wall like this to make sure that the mud and the waterproofing and there are no burrs that'll hold the wall out. The benefits to the ExoFrame are numerous. Here's an obvious one right here. This cast-in-place buck is bent sheet metal. It was set into the foundation. Concrete was cast around it. Often we see that these bucks begin to give way with time because of the load above. When we install the ExoFrame, it's going to mitigate for this. It's going to come back in and strengthen it because the ExoFrame is actually going to be touching the bottom of this, either directly or by shim. Typically, we cut the concrete, extract the block, then we set the ExoFrame. In this particular case today, to aid in the shooting of this video, we have installed this window well first, and we've installed a window well a little bit larger than what we normally do with our packages. This window well is 55 inches side to side. The window well that would normally go with this size window is 42 inches side to side. At Brighter Basements, we put safety first. Earplugs in, safety glasses on, and now we're ready for the ExoFrame. Got it. Okay, the ExoFrame's in place. We're gonna check it side to side to make certain that we're in the center of our opening. We're gonna check to be certain that our butyl is going to touch the brick up here. In this particular case, we're about a quarter of an inch out. So we're gonna roll it down just a bit. And after we install the ExoFrame, we're gonna come back and put a thin layer of grout right over the top to make sure that we have full contact all the way around. It's always a good idea to keep a hand or a finger on this ExoFrame. You don't wanna let go of it and then have it come fall on you and injure you. In this particular case, the cut is perfect. But if it weren't, we'd have these shims close by, and you'll have these in your kit, big shims and little shims. And if you needed to shim this, it's real easy. Just figure out which side you need the shim on. Tilt the ExoFrame back. Put the shim in. Push the ExoFrame back. The ExoFrame is pre-drilled with 5/16 inch holes, and this quarter inch drill bit will go right in this hole. So here we go. We're gonna switch tools now. 11 millimeter sockets on the end of the socket wrench. We do not drive that all the way home yet. Just enough to hold it into place. I look down at my level, Worcester level, and we're gonna continue, move on, and drill the last three holes. So we're gonna wrap up now, tightening the ExoFrame into place. It's secure now, so I'm just gonna go round around, just like you would if you were putting on a spare tire. Notice the butyl, how it's squeezed out of the frame here, and you can see what a great seal it makes. So I'm gonna tighten it a little more. Make sure, be certain, do not over-tighten these bolts, because if you do, you'll press down here and you'll distort the frame inward and your window won't fit. So do not over-tighten the ExoFrame. I want to point out a few other things. There's been foam applied between the foundation wall and the ExoFrame, and there's been a shim between the ExoFrame and the existing poured in place buck. This shim ensures that if there's ever any load bearing, that it comes directly down on the ExoFrame. So the window's going in now, bottom first. Thank you. Checking side to side. Quarter inch, your reveal good? Okay, so this little tool is supplied to you. It's something that we made in the shop just to assist in stabilizing the window from the outside. So now the person on the outside can hold the top of that little sheet metal tool, and we can simultaneously plumb the window. He has a level on the outside, and I have one on the inside, and we'll manipulate the window until we get it perfectly plumb. Then we'll drill our holes and put our fasteners in. Okay, we're perfect on this side. I'm perfect on this side. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to tap these straps in so that they conform to the cement without putting any stress on the window. And then we're going to take our hammer drill. It's already got a 3/16 inch bit in it. I keep my fasteners in my pocket, so it's just a simple lead fastener. We're going to put it in the hole that I just drilled, and we're going to take our hammer, and we're going to drive that home. We're going to double check our plumb again, and I do believe we're plumb, and we're going to switch to the other side. This side is plumb, so we're going to put a fastener in, drill a hole and put a fastener in. We are really close to being done. The only remaining thing to do is to use the appropriate fastener to fasten these last two straps. If you've got wood up here, you'd use a wood screw. If it's sheet metal like this, you'd use a self-tapping screw. If it was concrete, you'd use a lead head. We're going to remove our little tool here, set it to the side. Once again, a little foam, and we're done. So here we are, roughly a half an hour later. That's how long it should take to do this installation with two experienced guys. You've got an installation that is very well engineered. There's no wood. The installation basically takes the place of 8 pieces of wood and glued and caulked and screwed to the foundation wall. You've got a superior window, German tilt and turn technology. You should have decades of maintenance-free service out of this window. I'm Theo Stevens, inventor of the ExoFrame system. I have traveled all over the world looking for the best way to install a below-grade window. What you see here is a culmination of all the best ideas I've run across. I hope you agree.